If you feel stuck and you're tired of trying to figure out who you're supposed to be, then it may be time for a change. You're all wonderful women made of God with a wealth of potential within us, but oftentimes we can't access that potential. Why a lot of people feel stuck or held back, it's why it's so important to pursue transformation from the inside out, to live in the newness of the life that God wants you to live. This transformation involves surrendering your entire life to Jesus. Hi, beautiful ladies, and welcome back to Abide in Him. I'm so happy that you have taken the time to click on this video to watch. Today's video is going to be one that is about change. And it's something that we are all going to experience in one way or another. Change is about being transformed, discovering yourself, your new life in Christ, becoming a new woman. One thing that God loves to do is transform people. He meets you one way and then you don't remain the same way when you truly encounter God. And so this has happened in my life and I'm still in the process, and then you probably are as well. But if you're feeling stuck or struggling with this process, perhaps you're not even in the process at all, today's video is for you. I love to make videos to encourage women. If you are interested in content like that, please subscribe and let's get right into the video. So the steps that I'm going to share with you today are things that I've done personally that's helped me in my journey with God from the beginning, and things that I'm still doing, because honestly, this process is something that we are always going to be on. There is no end to growth. There's no end to transformation. God is always seeking to make us more and more like Christ, make us into what he's called us to be. So first thing that I wanted to share with you today is that you have to dedicate your life to God, or rededicate depending on where you are in your walk with God. Don't be new without God. He is the one who gives us newness of life. He has promised this in his word, and this is one of the reasons that Christ died for us, that we may live in newness of life through him, through his spirit living inside of us. So like I said, encountering God changes everything. So to begin your journey of becoming a new woman, you have to have a relationship with God. There is no shortcut to this, and that is why I'm mentioning this first. Prayer and the word, asking God to reveal himself to you and show you who he has made you to be. This will help you to grow closer to him, and the closer you get to him, the more of yourself, your true self, that you also become. When this happens, you will then see changes in your thoughts, your actions, your attitudes, your behavior, your character altogether. Also, you find old habits and behaviors, you know, falling away as you draw closer to Christ as well. This isn't a one-day process, something that can take time depending on the area that needs more of a change, but it is worth it in the end. So the second thing that I wanted to share with you, let go of the old. My goodness. People struggle to experience newness in Christ, to become the woman he has made us to be, because we are so fixated on who we once were. We are so fixated on the comfort and the familiarity of the old, that thing you've been used to for so many years of your life, and now you're saying, Lord, I want to take you seriously. I want to become the woman you made me to be. But you know what? I don't want to let go of this area just yet. And it doesn't work like that. We can't have these two things. You can't make progress in the new if you keep holding on to the old. This means letting go of our old sinful habits and nature, and embracing a new way of living that is in line with God's will and God's word. Ladies, you have to be willing to let go of the old in order to fully embrace the new. So the third thing that we have to do is to take care of your soul. Your soul matters a lot. This life, or walking with God, isn't only about the spiritual side of things. Your soul matters, your emotional health matters, and God does care about this. The thing is, I did make a video one time about finding comfort in God, about God being somebody you can actually go to, you know, unburden yourself, to share your thoughts with, your emotions, your feelings with, because he does care. He does understand us more than anyone else actually does. The Bible says in 3 John verse 2 that, beloved, I pray that you may prosper in all things and be in health just as your soul prospers. So you see that the other areas of our lives are really, really affected by how our soul is doing. And if your thought life isn't on track, and you know, if you don't have that peace, if your emotions are always disturbed, always in pain, always unstable, if your mental attitudes are not in line with God's word, it means they're not renewed, right? The rest of your life will also be affected, because truly newness of life does start from within, and what we see on the outside is truly a result of what God is doing on the inside of us, or wants to do on the inside of you. Please take time for yourself. Have more time for self-reflection. Have more time to have quiet times with God. Pick up positive habits like journaling and writing down your thoughts and your emotions. These things will truly help your soul to prosper as well. And also, last but not least, be very, very prayerful about the things that are going on inside of you. God will do something new and powerful inside of you. Okay, another thing that I had to do was to actually get serious about my life. For many years, I was just literally floating and coasting through life, thinking like, you know, whatever happens, happens. Yeah, I hope to get a job someday. I was going through school and all that stuff, right? But it's like, I wasn't really taking my life seriously. I had no sense of direction. I had no sense of purpose. I had probably funny goals. Like, I wasn't very serious as a woman, you know, and that's one of the things I really, really had to change. And I began to think about things like, what are my dreams? What is my purpose? What legacy do I want to leave behind? What impacts do I want to make in people's lives? What am I going to leave behind for my future children? You know, so when I began to think like that more and more seriously, I also began to be inspired by other women as well. I also began to take learning and gaining knowledge very seriously. This impacted the way that I thought about life. My mindset was improved, and I began to also take action in terms of like obeying God's will and purposes for my life, because honestly, we can't always be like, yo, I don't know. Like, we have to take action. We can't remain in that place of comfort, spending more time looking at other people's lives, them making progress in their lives, and us feeling bad about ourselves. Like, it's about time that we stop doing that now. Gee, rise up to the occasion and rise up, you know, to becoming that woman that God has called you to be. She is inside of you. You have to actually behave like her in faith, and slowly, consistently over time, you will see yourself becoming her. The fifth thing that I've worked on, and I still do work on sometimes, is literally how I speak to myself. So in order to become experience change and be new women, we have to be mindful of how we speak to ourselves. It's like, sometimes we speak to ourselves in a way that we wouldn't want to speak to other people, or in a way that we would stop our best friends from speaking to themselves about. By that I mean negative self-talk. This is actually something that, and negative self-talk is basically something we do a lot, like girls do a lot, right? This can also tie into insecurities as well, and, you know, feelings of discouragement, and talking to yourself negatively about like maybe you're not good enough, you can't do it, you're thinking you'll never change, thinking that things you're meant to be struggling, you're working with God, but that's not God's mind for you. And a lot of this talk truly does come from the enemy, but you think it's your own thoughts. And we have to deal with the root of those, and also spend time daily renewing our minds. The more you spend time in the Word of God, the less likely you'll be susceptible to having thoughts like this. And another form of negative self-talk is also like beating yourself up about the process that God is taking you through. For example, I used to beat myself up a lot in terms of like feeling like, oh, like I haven't changed everything that needs to change yet. Like being so impatient with myself, the process, like expecting myself to be like the version of me that maybe God wants me to be, you know, 10 years in my walk with him, but I want it to be like in year one, year two. Like, I'm like, chill. And all of the time, that does slow down our growth, because if you're focused so much on the negative sides about you, you don't take time to appreciate the positive sides, that the transformation, the change that God has already made inside of you. You're not appreciating the work that he has begun in you, and he promises that he will bring that work to completion. So appreciate how amazing you are, and you're still worth a lot to God. You're still so lovable, so valuable to God, even if you haven't made in your mind what seems to be a lot of progress. So the final thing I want to share about, it's not the prettiest part of the process, is allowing God to prune you. And, you know, God says in John 15 verse 2 that branch that doesn't bear fruit, he will prune so that it will bear fruit. Your characters, their behaviors, and things that God will always want to cut away, always want to prune out. So like, it's like a gardener would do, right? To chip away anything that is unnecessary, or pluck out weeds that impact the growth of the plant. God does that for his daughters as well, because he cares. He cares about our progress. And sometimes you are making progress, even if you might see one or two weeds or whatever it is. God wants to prune out of you. So, and sometimes the issue is that these weeds can like go undetected. Sometimes you might not notice. That's why it's good to always be spending time with Him, be prayerful, and also like and be open to being open to know that you are still a work in progress, and there are things that may still need change, but it doesn't mean that altogether you haven't made progress. It doesn't mean that you're a bad person. You know the characters that you need to have, know what you shouldn't have, and being prayerful about it, and God, you know, pray to God to transform you, to change you inside out, to remove whatever is a desire, to cleanse your mental attitude, your thought life. And the beautiful part about all of this, everything that I've said today, is that God actively is with us in the process. The Holy Spirit is with us to help. He is our helper. We're not alone. We don't change ourselves. We shouldn't rely on our efforts or abilities, but rather depending on God. Pray for all of these things, and truly just surrendering all to God. If you've come this far in the video, remember to enjoy the journey that you are on. I'm learning to. I want to do more of that this year. Enjoy the journey that I am on, and not overwork myself mentally and put too much pressure than I need to, but also being honest with myself and God. If you have any tips you want to show other women on how to embrace the woman you dream of becoming, let me know. If you also try the tips and steps that I've shared as well, thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that it has helped you, my beautiful ladies, and I'll see you guys on next week's video. Bye guys.